Hi everyone, I am Ajay Ramaswamy from University of Florida. Welcome to my project presentation for the graduate coursework Pattern Recognition, Spring 2017. My project is titled A Vision-Based Sudoku Solver Based on Feature Extraction and Optical Character Recognition. I'm going to start with a brief discussion on the motivation behind this project and then move on to explain the various techniques I've used. I've used Python to implement this application. I will also be going over the algorithm of my Sudoku solver application before outlining the possible future scope in this project. With regards to motivation, pattern recognition is present almost everywhere today. From Google image search to e-commerce product suggestions, almost everything involves pattern recognition. Feature extraction is currently an integral step in most modern machine learning, pattern recognition, and image processing applications. Most algorithms today work on large input data sets that result in huge amount of processing time overhead. Feature extraction aims to optimize the processing time overhead by eliminating useless and redundant information and providing only the necessary set of features. The reduced set of features is often referred to as a feature vector and is used extensively in dimensionality reduction. Patterns can be recognized from real-world data usually by either training a system with similar data and teaching it the difference between different classes or by predictive clustering. These two methods are called supervised and unsupervised learning respectively. In my project, I've used supervised learning algorithms to train and classify digits from a Sudoku image and solve the puzzle. This slide illustrates the steps involved in my project. It starts off with dataset preparation, then moves on to determining the Sudoku puzzle box from the input image using contour reduction. Then we need to isolate each of the 81 grid cells from the Sudoku puzzle box using predictive cropping. Once we do that, we can identify all the individual number digits from each cell using optical character recognition, which is achieved using a feature extractor and a classifier. Finally, the Sudoku puzzle is solved by feeding in the recognized input number set from the previous step into a Sudoku solver algorithm that displays back the solved puzzle onto the output puzzle image using perspective warping. I will now go over each step in some more detail. So the first step is dataset preparation. This is an important step as training data plays a huge role in improving the accuracy of the application. A more elaborate training data would result in a better optical character recognition. I have prepared a dataset containing consisting of 10 sets of number images from 1 to 9 by extracting digits from the actual Sudoku puzzle. This number 2 over here is an example of such a number in such a dataset. For 0, for representing the number 0, we actually use a blank image. These number images are then cropped to their contours using contour reduction. And image pre-processing is applied to these images to increase the accuracy of the classifier. The pre-processing stage consists of four steps, RGB image to grayscale conversion, Gaussian blur to eliminate the noise, histogram equalization, and adaptive thresholding. The end result is a binary image, which is shown right here. This is the image after pre-processing. The next step would be contour reduction. Before we even apply contour reduction, the Sudoku input image is pre-processed using the same four steps I mentioned previously. The image is first converted to grayscale, then a Gaussian blur pattern is obtained on the image, followed by histogram equalization and adaptive thresholding. The pre-processed Sudoku image would then look like something like this on the right-hand side. After the image is pre-processed, it is provided as an input to a module which identifies the contours in that frame. The contours are identified as edges in an image that form a closed loop. So the image contours obtained in this step are usually mostly squares and rectangles from the Sudoku puzzle. Actually, different contours in the image are directed and only the contours resembling a rectangle or a square is chosen. The algorithm directs the biggest rectangle on the screen from the contours and determines if it is a Sudoku puzzle box or not. Like for example, you can see this rectangle, the biggest rectangle in the Sudoku box is directed using the contour direction. And then this rectangle or square is tested for grids and numbers inside it. If no grids or numbers are found, it is not the Sudoku puzzle box, so it is eliminated and the next biggest rectangle or square is chosen for further analysis. In the next step, perspective warping is performed on the predicted contoured rectangle image to convert it into a 2D image. The warp image is then subjected to additional pre-processing to remove unnecessary noise speckles and is then resized to a standard 500x500 image. Each individual grid box is then isolated from the puzzle by predictively cropping based on the cell size. This splits the Sudoku box into 81 different grids. So each grid would look something like this with the number in it. The objective of this step is to prepare all the individual grids for applying the optical character recognition process and extract these numbers from the boxes. From the extracted cell blocks, the digit contours are obtained using a similar contour direction technique. You can see an example image right here, the number 6 with a red rectangle enclosure. However, before performing character recognition, the image is again pre-processed by converting it to a grayscale image. A Gaussian blur pattern is also obtained on the image, followed by histogram equalization. The image is finally converted into a binary image using adaptive thresholding, the same old story for pre-processing. After extracting the number and pre-processing it, we now move on to the optical character recognition stage. This stage involves the primary pattern recognition techniques like dimensionality reduction, feature extraction, and classification. This slide describes the dimensionality reduction step. The obtained digit images, numbered images, are converted to a standard 20x20 size, which implies that each digit image has 400 feature dimensions. This number of dimensions can actually be reduced using a technique called dimensionality reduction to improve the computational speed. There are several algorithms used to achieve dimensionality reduction. Principal component analysis is one such algorithm. Principal component analysis involves the transformation of the digits from pixel space to eigenspace. These eigenvectors are then arranged in the decreasing order of their variance. From these eigenvectors, only the initial few are chosen. Maximum energy is stored in the initial few eigenvectors, and hence by choosing lesser than 400 eigenvectors, the feature dimensions and the computational space can be reduced. Feature extraction step, which is the second step, involves the extraction of important feature information from the image to improve prediction accuracy. There are many different feature extractors such as SIFT, SURF, EBGM, and LBPH, which is actually local binary pattern histogram. In this project, I've used the local binary pattern histogram technique to extract the texture features from the digit image, the number image. Local binary pattern histogram is also computationally less expensive, and hence that's the reason why I've chosen this particular technique. This step returns a normalized histogram vector. The classification step involves to train a classifier and predict the digit images. Many different classifiers ranging from support vector machines, neural networks, and k-nearest neighbor can be used. In this project, I've used k-nearest neighbor for classifying the feature vectors. K-nearest neighbor is a relatively simple classifier with less computational complexity. It finds the k-nearest neighbors of the query image, K can be chosen to be 1 here to obtain the closest class image. Based on the predicted information from the classifier, the Sudoku puzzle is solved using a Sudoku solver module. The Sudoku solver algorithm was written based on how a Sudoku puzzle is generally solved on paper without using any specific pre-existing algorithm. This algorithm was programmed in Python. All the aforementioned steps have been programmed using Python, given how user-friendly the language is. Let me give a brief explanation on how this algorithm works. The algorithm first finds the number of non-zero elements in each row and each column to start with. Then it chooses the row or column with the maximum number of non-zero elements. It tries to find if there are any locations that can be filled without any ambiguity and fills them. If no update can be made on these rows and columns, the other rows and columns are subject to the search and update process. If no spot can be filled without ambiguity, the program returns by throwing an error. Once a spot is actually filled in the Sudoku puzzle, it repeats the entire process again from the beginning. So this process continues until all the spots are filled in the puzzle from numbers 1 to 9. The function finally returns with the solved or the unsolved puzzle and a Boolean value to indicate if the puzzle has actually been solved or not. The algorithm mentioned, which I just described, solves for the puzzle and returns the filled vector containing 81 numbers. Based on the empty locations in the puzzle, the solved numbers are then displayed back onto the Sudoku puzzle. This is done by first replacing the empty locations in the puzzle with the number images and then warping the puzzle back onto the frame. This way, the solved puzzle is displayed on the screen, and this is how the solution output will be displayed on the screen. So this is the end result which we obtained from the application, the solved Sudoku puzzle with the, if you see, these are the numbers which are solved, the blurred ones. So this concludes my project description. Moving on to the future scope of this project. This project actually works only on still images. It takes in one single image as the input and then solves the puzzle. So this can be extended as a real-time application by showing a Sudoku puzzle to the camera, obtaining image frames at the real-time, and processing the Sudoku puzzle image to obtain the solved puzzle. To do this, we have to find the Sudoku contour, warp it to a 2D image, and then perform all the steps described, which I described in the previous slides. Finally, we must warp the displayed image in my project to the location of the puzzle in the real time frame. As a performance optimization in the Sudoku solving stage for the real time system, this particular stage, the answers for the puzzles, the solved puzzles, can be stored so that they don't have to be solved for every frame and can almost be instantly solved from memory. Another scope of improvement is that if time complexity is not a factor of consideration, then neural networks can also be used as a classifier. That would give an improved accuracy, in my opinion. It can certainly be implemented to, to perform a comparative analysis with the other existing techniques. Before I conclude with my presentation, I would like to thank Professor Dr. Tepang Olivabu for his timely help and support towards the success of this project. His engaging and creative method of teaching inspired us to approach problems with a better perspective and provided us with an in-depth working knowledge of various pattern recognition techniques. So that's the end of my project video presentation. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a nice day.